Well, currently my story that I'm have been working on for the past 2 years is working inside North Korea. So this is a country that there's almost no photography that comes out of the country, almost no independent visual record of North Korea. What few pictures come out are propaganda that's distributed by the North Korean state. So I have had a chance to work there. I'm the first Western photojournalist with regular access inside North Korea. So if there was ever a place to test the power of photography, it's here. It's a place where there's no photography. So now I'm there, I'm walking the streets of North Korea, a place that's a black hole to people. People have no idea what it's like. And so photography is a very simple tool for me, but it's a very powerful one. I can just simply open a window onto this place that without photography, people would have no even idea, no way to imagine what it looks like inside there.
I was traveling with a woman who was studying the transmission of monkeypox. And monkeypox is a really dreadful disease. In the case of Norbert, the young man in the photograph, it was a profoundly disturbing case. A number of months later, he died. I think that people don't understand when they see photographs that are disturbing, they don't understand that you are in large part powerless to change the fate of that person. There are some people you just have a connection with that you need in the field because you know that they're consciously making a contribution and allowing you to be present in their life and to photograph them, even though they are at their smallest, their weakest, their saddest. That's an act.
After dropping out of high school, I found myself running up against all sorts of, you know, people who were telling me what to do, how to do it, that I was screwed up, that I wasn't going to succeed, that I was on the wrong path, and that became very important for me to, I guess, to prove people wrong. And it became this way to tell the story of sort of struggle that I was feeling internally. And I express that through climbing and then through the story of climbing through photography. I realized that being in these places was an incredible way to tell a story, to show what it feels like to be reduced to nothing willfully and push through that and to cry and struggle and be rubbed raw, you know, in a way that a lot of people don't ever get to experience. And taking photos of that allows people that experience on some level. The images that speak to me are the ones that make me feel. They're the ones that make your hair stand up on the back of your neck or give you goosebumps. If my photographs in any way make somebody feel fear or joy or love or vulnerability, I've succeeded. You could be in the dirtiest place in the world with the most smog in the world. You could be someplace where, generally speaking, nobody thinks of beauty, but if somebody's living, you know, really living and showing that human experience, that to me is the beauty of the landscape. Every single place we are, there's incredible amounts of just raw human and natural beauty happening.
98% of the livable, habitable planet where animals can live is ocean. And yet, less than 5% of the world's oceans have truly been explored. So for a storyteller, for a journalist, it really is a perfect place to work because there's limitless amounts of stories and subjects down there to find. It's the soul of the sea that I'm trying to capture, this life force that exudes from certain animals and the spirit that you can capture. You don't get it all the time, but when you do, it's quite magical. Whether I'm swimming with sharks or whales or sea turtles or tiny creatures, nudibranchs or little shrimp, there's always stories to be told. And it's a discovery process. You know, for me, as I sort of connect the dots and spend time with these animals, I begin to see things. Things are revealed to me. It's like peeling an onion. Every layer, you're getting deeper into it and you're seeing more. It's a never-ending process, and photography allows the reader and the photographer to truly explore this unknown realm. Never underestimate the power of a still frame. I feel very passionately about wanting to wake people up and save the planet. I have two young daughters at home, and I want them to see a bluefin tuna. I want them to swim with a whale or a dolphin. Over the 35 years that I've been diving and exploring the ocean, I began to see a lot of degradation, things that probably weren't evident to most people because it's happening below the surface, off the radar. As a journalist, I felt a sense of duty and a sense of urgency to begin turning my cameras towards those stories as well. We're not operating in a vacuum. Human beings, you know, can't exist alone. We need nature around us. And the more we know about nature, the better I think we will be in terms of just living in harmony with it.
Photography allows you to be kind of the anomaly and to be able to be the person in the place no one else can go. That it kind of, it pushes those doors open in front of us. But photography has the power to undo your assumptions about the world. We assume so many things about what's out there, and I think all of this great photography just shatters that. That's a great place to be. There are different levels to success as a photographer, in quotes. You know, there's the aesthetic success, but there's the whole other side where does your work make an impact in the world? Does it educate? Does it change people's lives? Does it make a difference? To follow the path of your heart is important, whether you're making pictures or anything else. That's all that matters ultimately. You can't, well, if it's a 7-year project on a reservation or elsewhere, like if your heart's not in it, it's probably not worth doing. I was given so much time to work on this assignment that I was able to spend, you know, days not shooting. I think it's reshaped like how I engage with people on a really deep kind of heart level. It kind of taught me that it was okay to like lose my strict role as an observer. And I think great photography, and especially the photography of this magazine, wakes people up to the diversity of the world and to the lives that are so different than our own. We get our blinders on and we see our version of the world and we think that it's the center of the universe. But if we do not supplement great journalism and photojournalism with the voice and images of the people, whether trained or not, we will never be able to tell the truth.
I fall in love, you know, every day. And I fall in love with almost every subject I photograph. And I love them. I want to spend time with them. I want to hear their stories. I want to get closer. I don't want to lose touch. Whether or not I agree with their practices or what they're doing, I do believe that most people in this world are good people and that we have a lot to learn from them. Photography has the power to change your perspective on life. It has the power to help you make decisions on the way you want to live your life. The Child Marriage Project has definitely been an incredible experience. I've seen the way photography can make incredible change. When people see those photographs, I hope they are overcome with a sense of urgency. I hope that they are moved and can see themselves as a child in that situation, or their daughter or niece or someone else in that situation. That they want to do something and that they don't forget the photographs. When I was younger, I didn't understand why there were no women, or very few women in our profession. I'm 39 years old now, and you know, I don't have children yet. And so I'm kind of facing the repercussions of that, but I understand now kind of some of the limitations that are out there for women. And when we do have kids, I know that there will be some changes I'll have to make in certain stories I take and what I continue to do. We'll never understand communities that are not like ourselves without time. Time is something that you need for a great photography. Everyone can take a good picture, especially now. But to take great photographs, you need time, you need patience, you need support, and National Geographic gives you that.